Welcome back to my channel, friends. This side Sonia here from Growing Craft, and welcome back with another live session on our Facebook page. And I hope many of you will join us. So I'm just waiting for a few more people to join in. And yes, of course, we have another giveaway with this live session. So please do not forget to share this session as much as you can, and you can see some of the amazing goodies on my table right now. So yeah, what are we going to create today is something which I love doing. And what are we planning to create today is very simple, very easy. I know many of you have been asking me for this session since long time, and finally I could plan this one. And yes, do not forget to participate in our giveaway. What you need to do is you need to share this video on different Facebook groups in the public mode. And yes, you need to make sure that you share this in varieties of group. And yes, I can see many of you have joined me already. And hello everyone. I'm super happy. So Mondays and Fridays are my day when I have literally got the panic attack, when I know that I have to come live. But then the moment I start the session, I am like super happy to see you all, and to see the response what you all guys give me, and it's absolutely amazing. So first thing first, do check our YouTube channel where we have already shared the video on the image transfer with Dress Minecraft, transfer me sheet. So these are a few of the projects which I have done. I still need to upload the video on this one. This looks absolutely gorgeous, and this is one of my favorite projects with the transfer me. So you will be seeing all these videos on our YouTube channel. That's Growing Craft on YouTube. So do not forget to subscribe to that. And now moving on to the next thing what we are making today. Okay, so many of you had asked me that how to create gift boxes. Like, we all have tons of boxes lying around at our place, but we really don't know what to do with it, because when it is something of this kind, you love it but you can't use it, because of course you don't like too much of branding, and we are not promoting that at all. So here are a few of the boxes. The video tutorials of all these boxes are already there on my YouTube channel. I'll just share the link with you all so that you all can watch these videos. And yes, what we are going to create today is something really interesting. Like, let me tell you, honestly speaking, I'm running out of my black color acrylic paint. I'm running out of my black color gesso. So how to do a nice mixed media and decoupage work? So I thought, why not to do something related to this, so that I can share with you that even with the very basic supplies you can create something beautiful. Now this is a tin box which I have, and yes, we are going to alter this one. Now first of all, before starting the video, many of you have asked me that how to cover up this part of your box. No, you do not have to cover this one, because of the constant use, it is just going to get damaged. So what you need to do is mark it with a pen or a pencil. Okay, like here, I will just mark with my pen that how much area we need. Then take an Abro tape and cover the remaining part. This is really important. This Abro tape is available at any of the stationery or the hardware store, so you can buy it from there, and you don't have to pay for shipping charges for these things at least. Yes, today also we have a giveaway. For our previous giveaway, the winners have been already announced on our YouTube channel, so please do check that to know the winners of our previous giveaways. And in today's session, we are going to give two MDF cutting packs to the two lucky winners. One is going to each one is going to get one pack of MDF cutout. So please do make sure that you share this video as much as you can. Okay, now here what I have done is I have just covered the lid part, which is going to overlap with my Abro tape. Now, why I have done is because I know that on those parts, even if I do the paint, it is just going to be rubbed too many times while opening the container. So that's the reason I have just sealed it right now. Now, like I said, I'm running out of my black color, actually paint, black color gesso. So what I am going to do is I am going to start with my white color heavy gesso. Okay, this is one of the very important things which I always say, that having gesso, the heavy gesso really helps, and Finnabare is something which I absolutely love. Now, the links of all these supplies have been already mentioned on our Facebook page. You can check it from there, and I hope you will like this. And yes, I'm so happy that we have crossed 20,000 followers. So my target is 200,000 followers. So I just keep on saying that only. But we have just crossed 20,000 followers, which is a so proud moment for me, because I absolutely enjoy coming and joining with you all, and seeing you all coming around and joining me gives me so much of happiness. So here I am taking a bigger sponge dauber so that I can do it quickly. Okay, why I am doing my white gesso right now, because I'm running out of black gesso. So that's the reason I have taken up this one. Now, for this process, you will be needing your heat gun. So please do make sure that you have your heat guns ready with you, because we will have to dry this up very, very quickly. Now, the winners of our resin live session has been announced on our Facebook YouTube channel. So please do not miss out that part. And yes, like I mentioned earlier, we have done some of the amazing image transfer tutorials on our YouTube. So do check that at Growing Craft on YouTube. Okay, so here I am almost done. So usually what happens is, even if with just one coat of gesso, many a times we end up seeing the background color. So that's the reason I'm doing my white color gesso now. And I need to find an alternate for black color gesso, and I have something already in my mind. So what I need to do is I need to make sure that it works out. Okay, now here I am done with my gesso work. I have just shared the link of our YouTube channel. You can check that, and there you will also find like more than 500 videos which are absolutely free for all of you to watch. Okay, now here I am done. Now we will be covering the lid part. Just because we have already added the tape, this makes our work so much easier. And yeah, I can see few of your comments, and I hope I will be able to reply to all of them. But in case if you want me to reply to any of your queries, please comment on any of our YouTube videos and I'll definitely reply back. Since 15 days I've been doing that only, and I'm happy and I'm glad that I was able to do that. Do not forget to participate in our giveaway. Please do make sure that you share this session as much as on the social media. And I hope it works out. Okay, so here I'm done with my white gesso. Now, very quickly, I will be using my heat gun to dry this up. So I'm more concerned about my lid, because on the lid we have to work a lot. So yeah, it will take a little time for me to dry this out. So we have some of the very interesting supplies today to share with you all. So now these are the bright white granules stones which we have, and yes, it works perfectly fine with any of your mixed media and your decoupage projects. Now if you don't have a sponge dauber, you can use the sponge pieces, but there is a difference. So usually the handle makes it much more easier to work around it. Okay, So that's the reason I suggest sponge dauber. But if you don't have a sponge dauber, you can always use either your paint brushes or any your scrap piece of sponge. It's absolutely fine. Now we need to start with the sticking part, and here is one of the nice MDF embellishments which iCraft has sent me for their live session, which I had not used it there, but I'm using it today. And yes, all the supplies link have been mentioned, so please do not forget to check that. I have mentioned all the supplies with the link so that it's easier for all of you to buy that. I know because of the lockdown we cannot go out, and whole this corona thing is going crazy everywhere, and that's the reason we are trying to come up with varieties of artwork so that you all can try something. And yes, if you have not joined our Facebook group, that's in the name of Growing Craft, where you can share your artwork and inspire us, please do that. Now to stick this one, here I'm not using any of the fancy mediums. Here I'm using my regular Fevicol. So here I'm almost done. Now with my fingers I'm just going to dab all my adhesive on maximum areas, and now I will stick this. So today we are altering a old tin box. So yes, we have been traveling, and we have tons of these kind of boxes. Sorry girls, please do not forget to share this video as much as you can, because we are having a giveaway for this live session also. And for that, what you need to do is you need to share this video as much as you can, and that's going to be a great help for us. Now the very interesting part, here I have taken up my liquid adhesive. I'm going to keep this in a tray so that clearing up my mess becomes easier. And now I'm just going to have my liquid adhesive not on my MDF part, but on the remaining part of my box. Okay, this is a very important step. Do not miss out this one. You don't have to be very particular about this thing. It's just that you need to make sure that you don't do anything on MDF base right now. You need to put up the adhesive only on the sides of the MDF base. So here I can see that I have almost done it. Now this is the very fine granules which I have. I hope this is clear. And now I'm going to sprinkle this on my box very quickly, and I'll try to cover up as much as I can. Okay. Thank you so much everyone for joining us. This is absolutely a pleasure for me to come online and see all of you joining us. Now as you can see that this is looking absolutely gorgeous. Let me just give you a closer look of this one, but I need to add few more stones here there. So we are doing this work only on the lid part. Why? Because on the bottom we really don't have to. Okay, now let me just show you that this is how it looks. This looks fab. This looks amazing. The granules are looking so cute, so nice, so beautiful. Now what we are going to do is, let me clean up this everything so that it's easier for me to work on this counter. Okay, now we are going to have our liquid adhesive. So here is a plain base. On this I've taken up my liquid adhesive. Now I'm going to take some clean water on my paint brush, and I will try to make a thin paste of this. So here what I have taken is my liquid adhesive, and I am going to make sure that I coat this very nicely on my granules. So now this is a very important step. Right now the granules are a little wet, so you need to either you can wait for some time to dry it out, or what you can do is you can Just be a little gentle with these and then you can use it. So here I'll take some more liquid adhesive. I'll add some more water to it. So all these granules and all the supplies link have been mentioned. So you can buy them from all those links available. And yes, I love using these granules for my mixed media and for my decoupage projects. And they look fab. They look absolutely, absolutely fab. Okay. Even if you have joined us now, do not worry, this video is going to be there on our Facebook page and I will be posting this on our YouTube channel also. So you don't have to worry about this at all. So the granules what I'm using is the white or natural granules. Let me just share the link of this granule so that you can all can buy this directly. I have just posted the link on the comment section. You can check that and you can place your order. And I have also mentioned the link for the MDF cuttings, and this will make your work easier. And just imagine, like in the same way, you can do this on the cardboard boxes. Like if you have just seen our previous video on Facebook, which I had posted, that was done completely on a cardboard box. So you can even add textures to it. You can add some nice colors to it and they will look fab. Absolutely fab. Okay, so here I am almost done. See, whatever the extra is, it is going to come out anyways. So do not worry, even while working, it is going to come out. But then that's absolutely fine because that is going to be the extra part. Now here I'm done with my granule work. Now what we need to do is we need to use our heat gun so that it dries up fast and so that we can move on to the next step. And yes, do not forget to share this video as much as you can, because two lucky winners are going to get the MDF cutout packs from us. And yes, the previous live session winners have been announced on our YouTube channel. That's Growing Craft on YouTube, so you can check it there. And yes, so today we are altering the boxes. So this box video is already there on my YouTube channel. You can check that. Like this was done with the clay and resin work. And this was done with the decoupage technique and with the nice colors and decoupage work and the blending work. So this looks fab. This is one of my favorites. And this is the absolutely gorgeous project which I had done like few months back. Okay, now here I need to be a little patient because this is going to take too much of time to dry out. So yeah, I will have to use my heat gun. If you don't have a heat gun, you can just let it dry naturally. Or what you can do is you can use your hair dryer just to dry this out. Now as I have used my liquid adhesive, it is going to have some of the side effects. It's that it is going to pop up. So what you need to do is at some point of time you will have to keep on pressing these so that it sticks well to your base. Okay, and do not worry, do not worry about it at all. It is going to turn out to be really good. Okay, yeah, this is almost done. I'm done with most of the areas. Now here is a very, very important step and a very interesting step. Like I said, I am running out of my glue, my black color gesso and my black color chalk acrylic paint. So what I'm going to do is I will be taking up my heavy gesso. Let me take up another palette. Okay, so here I've taken up my acrylic block. Now in this I'm going to have, because I wanted to have a darker color here. So what I'm going to do is I am going to have my brown shade to it. Okay, why I'm doing this? Because I'm running out of black gesso. If you have a black gesso, you can always use that. and it's absolutely fine, but here I need to add some of the darker shades to make sure that it takes up a darker color. So just adding up some darker shades is going to help me a lot. So yeah, can you see this? This is actually looking very nice, very, very, very beautiful. And with this, I'm also going to save time with like blending of my colors, of course. Now, as I'm done with almost the mixing of the color, I will start applying this. And what you will be seeing is a beautiful color on my box. I hope this is visible. And I hope this is clear. Like I said, you need to be a little gentle because it has not dried out. Like here I'm doing a live session, that's why I have to be a little quick. But what you can do is you can keep on drying this for a good amount of time and then you can start having your colors on the top of it. So if you have a black gesso, you can directly do that, but I was running out of black gesso, that's why I thought of adding some nice acrylic paints on my heavy gesso. So yeah, this is almost done. I'll add in a bit more of blue color and I will be taking up some more of my black gesso, and for that I'll take up my palette knife so that I do not mix any of these extra colors to my gesso. Okay, now mix this well. This is one of the very, very important keys. And yes, please do make sure that you share this video as much as you can, because we are having another giveaway with this live session, and for that you need to share this video as much as you can, and that's going to be a great help for me, girl. So please do that. Now I'm just rubbing off my brush here and there, and this looks gorgeous. This looks absolutely beautiful. Make sure you mix your colors really well with your brush, and here I'm using a flat brush. All those links are mentioned in the video description box and also in the comment section, you can check that. Now let me just finish with this coloring box so that I can show you the nice texture work what this white granules have created over the time in this box, and this looks fab. So this is how it looks. This looks beautiful. Now I will be taking up a round brush. I'll just add a bit of water and I'll start rubbing off my round brush on my design so that I can even cover up the other parts of this box. Okay, now this is very important. Do not miss out this step at all. And yeah, this is looking fab. If you think that your paints and gesso are a little heavier, just add a tinge of water. You can always do that. There is no harm in adding few drops of water to your project. And yes, once you are done with that, then you can apply your colors. Please do share this video as much as you girls can, so that it's a great help for me, and it also lets me know that what all you want to learn because of your comments, because of your feedback. So do not forget to leave your feedbacks too. And yes, do check my YouTube channel, that's in the name of Growing Craft, where you can see more than 500 videos which are absolutely free for all of you. Now, I have already mentioned that I am coming up with some of the image transfer videos, and of course we are planning for a live session very, very soon. So please do stay tuned to our page, and yes, do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and also join our Facebook page where you can share your artwork and inspire us. Now here we are almost done. Now very quickly I will be using my heat gun to dry this out. If you don't have a heat gun, you can just let it dry naturally. Or what you can do is you can use your hair dryers also. Just in case if you want and substitute for these right granules, you get very beautiful craft stones in the market, you can try that. It depends on what kind of amount you are ready to spend. Otherwise, you get variety of craft supplies in the market. You can definitely check that. Now, very quickly, I'm just moving my heat gun because I want to make sure that it dries up fast. It stays and sticks very fast. Now with the same paint brush, I will be taking up my color, and for my lid, I just want to have a nice plain color. So I'm rubbing off my color on my gesso part. Even if it's coming on my tape part, it's absolutely fine, because once we remove the tape, that part is going to be absolutely clean and beautiful. So don't worry about that. So here I've taken a round brush. I think this number is 12. So I don't have to add too many stripes, just one or two lines, and this is done. Okay, yeah, we are almost done. Just make sure that you have applied your gesso well, you have let it dry completely, and use heavy gesso. I always say that try to use the heavy gesso, that gives a completely different look and feel to your project. Now very quickly I'll dry this up. As you can see that I already have an abro tape, so that's going to make sure that my upper part is not getting green because of my colors at all. And here I will be doing nice drying work with my heat gun. So yes, if you don't have a black gesso like me, do not worry about it. What you can do is you can always try out another shades, mix it up, match it up, and you will be so good to go. Yes, do not forget to participate in our giveaway. What you need to do is you need to share this video as much as you can, and two lucky winners are going to get MDF embellishments pack from Growing Craft. So yeah, do share this video as much as you can. And yes, we have crossed 10,000 subscribers on our YouTube channel. So yes, we are coming up with a huge giveaway on our Facebook page. So till then, keep on sharing and posting our projects. Okay, now here we are done. Now as you can see on some of the parts, I can see my background color. Don't worry. So here what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my color sprays. If you don't have color sprays, you can always try out your any of your acrylic colors or the paints, and they will work beautifully. Okay, now can you see this? This looks gorgeous and beautiful. Now very quickly we will start drying this up also. Yes, all the supplies link have been mentioned on our comment section. Do check that. And these boxes have been already done, and the video tutorial is there on our YouTube channel on how to create a beautiful box with your any of the old tin boxes or even with the cardboard boxes. There's no compulsion that you need to have tin boxes only. Even the cardboard boxes or your plastic boxes, they are going to work beautifully. The only the steps what you need to follow is the same what we have done right now in the live session. So you don't have to worry about anything. Few of the basic supplies and you are good to go. Okay, so here we are almost done. I'm just trying to make sure that it has dried out well so that we can move on to the next step. So that is very important. You need to make sure that it has dried out well. Okay, now this is done. Yeah, this is almost done. I'm just trying to make sure that it dries up well. And yes, the winners have been announced on our YouTube channel for the previous live session, so do check that. And of course you need to share this video also as much as you can so that we can share 2 packs of our MDF cutouts with you, and we would love to do that. Okay, now here I'm just trying to press this a little just to make sure that everything sticks well to my base and my texture has come out so well. And can you see this? This is very, very hot, so be a little careful when you are doing this. And this looks gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. Now here I have my shimmer paint. What you can do is you just need to take your shimmer paints and the metallic paints, and you need to take up your brushes or something. But I love doing this technique with my fingers, so I'll have just taken few dots. I'll just dab it on my lid and very gently I'll start covering up my texture. Okay, now let me just finish up some part so that I can show you that how my texture part is looking highlighted. Okay, and this looks absolutely gorgeous. Like, you can use these boxes for gifting jewelry, for chocolates, even like for the fest, as the festive season is coming up, you can use this in a varieties of ways, and they look so, so, so gorgeous. Yeah. Now let me finish the half of the part so that I can show you that even with just one nice paint, the whole project looks completely different. Yes, this looks absolutely, absolutely amazing. I am already loving this so much. So yes, every Monday and Friday we have live sessions on our Facebook page, so do not miss that at all. And of course you can even watch our videos on our YouTube channel, that's in the name of Growing Craft. And now let me show you that how this looks. Did you like it? Please do let me know if you liked it, and if you liked it, please do not hesitate to share this video, and I would really, really appreciate that. Very recently we have crossed 20,000 followers, and that's a huge, huge, huge thing for me. And like I said, we are coming up with a huge giveaway on our page, and I'm sure you are going to be part of this. Can you see this? This looks gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. Now let me finish the remaining part. And what I'm doing is with a very, very, very gentle fingers, I'm just rubbing off my metallic colors here and there. And yes, I'm going to make sure this becomes one of the best gifts what you guys can create and give to your loved ones, and I'm sure they are going to love this. So same technique has been done on this, but the difference is here I have just used my white color base. Here I have used a colorful base, and like I said, I am running out of black color gesso. So yeah, I don't have black color gesso at all in my stock. So that's the reason I thought of creating my own with the white heavy gesso, and this looks gorgeous. This looks beautiful. So even with this white granule, you can see, like, in this project, what I have done is I have just used two main supplies for the texture. One is this MDF cutout, and the other thing is this granule. I have not used any other element for the texture work, and you don't have to buy too many MDF cutouts and use it. No, it's not compulsory at all. Even with the very basic 2-3 supplies, you can create something amazing and something beautiful. The paint what I'm using right now is a shimmer paint. This is from Crafty Scrappers. I'm not sure if they still have this, but you can always try out with the metallic paints too. Even I think the iCraft also have some of the nice shades in the metallic paints, which look absolutely gorgeous and beautiful. And yes, do not forget to have your colors on the sides of your panel. Now can you see this? This looks beautiful. I am absolutely loving this, and I really hope that even you all are also enjoying this session. And yes, here we are almost done. Now on the bottom lid, what I'm going to do is I'll just rub off my metallic color. Okay, I don't want too much of metallic color on my base, and I don't want to have texture on the base. So that's the reason what I am doing is that I will be just spreading my shimmer paint here. You can use your metallic paints, you can use your glitters, and it's absolutely fine. Okay, so as I told you that today we are just going to have very very basic and the limited supply. So what is it? It is the white granules what we have used, and also the MDF cutout, and these two things are like so easily available. I have already mentioned the link. I have just commented the link of the white granules, and I hope that helps you all. And yeah, so here we are done. Now we are done with our paint, the shimmer paint, and now what we are going to do is I will very quickly remove my Apro tape because I'm so excited to show you that how my lid and the box has turned out, and this looks beautiful. Can you see this, how nicely and how neat my lines look because of the Apro tape? And even when I'm closing the box, it is not going to get ruined at all. Now, just in case if you all want to know that how this box looked previously, let me show you. So it was some this kind of metal box which has been turned into this variety. Now of course we will have to seal this up. For sealing this up, we will need a water-based varnish, which I absolutely love. I swear by that varnish. And yes, I have shared all the supplies link in the comment section. You can check that. And of course, all the links are going to be there on our Facebook page, on our posts. So do not miss out that. I have not used any powder here. What I have used is my white granules. I have already posted the link of this. Now here very quickly I'm using my heat gun to dry this up, and can you see that how beautiful my box looks after my coloring work? This looks absolutely gorgeous. Now very nicely what I need to do is I need to seal this up, and for sealing this up I'm going to use my varnish, and this is a water-based varnish which I love. And yes, did I forget to mention that Anukul's paint brushes are still available on our website, so do not miss that. And very quickly I'll just put up a coat of varnish on the bottom part first and then on my lid, because I want to show you that how my lid part works beautifully, and this looks gorgeous. Just imagine gifting something like this to your loved ones, or even I use these for my teeny mini things which I have to keep and store with us. Okay, now I'll just dab up my varnish. You need to make sure that you generously apply your varnish, and these boxes, whenever you are doing these boxes, at least 3 coats of varnish is a must, because it has loads of texture. So what you need to make sure is that it stays well, it lasts longer, and for that you need to have your generous amount of varnish. Now whenever you are doing varnish, you need to make sure that you have like varnish in layers, and before each layer the previous layer should dry out completely, then only move on to the next layer, so that it is absorbed by your supplies really well and it stays well. Yeah, so if you can just see, I'm not brushing off my varnish. I'm not at all like doing this with the varnish. I am applying this with my paintbrush and I'm dabbing the varnish. So the varnish what I'm using here is an Asian Paint varnish. I have a video tutorial on my YouTube where I have explained about the varnishes. Let me just share that with you, and that's going to be a great help for all of you for sure. So yeah, I have just mentioned the link of the varnishes on my comment section. Do check that. So yeah, here we are done. This looks fab. This looks beautiful. This looks gorgeous. And I'm happy. I'm really, really, really happy. So I hope it was clear. I hope you all liked it. And converting these kind of metal boxes to a beautiful gift boxes is super easy. You just need few of the basic supplies and you are done. And like I said, in this one, I have just used two of the things. One was this wooden embellishments and the other thing was this white granules. And we could create this something beautiful. And these are few of the projects which I have done previously. And all these videos are there on our YouTube channel. Do check that. That's in the name of Growing Craft. Do not miss out to follow us on Instagram and do join our Facebook group where you can share your artwork and inspire us. And yes, we are coming up with a huge, huge, huge giveaway on our Facebook page and our YouTube channel. Do check that. And thank you so much for watching, guys. Take care. Bye-bye. So yeah, Vanya is here just in case. Vanya, do you want to say hi?
Hello.
Yeah, so Vanya is late today because she was doing her own work and we are off to say goodbye, Vanya, now. We'll say bye.
Bye.
Yeah. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. Take care. Bye-bye.